Hi, ajmahari here. Are you somebody who's in a relationship right now, dating a borderline, loving a borderline, or like dating or in a relationship right now, or you've already been ghosted many times and or discarded, and you're kind of in that limbo place, or really struggling with not being able to stop ruminating the cognitive dissonance, kind of knowing it's over, but still really missing that person with BPD? Well, what you need to know now, I mean, what I want to talk about right now might not help people who've already got involved with a person with BPD and you've already gotten hurt, but I just wanted to clarify something. So when you did get with the person with BPD, when the relationship started, or if you're newer to this and you're dating somebody with BPD and you're just figuring it out now, have you been ignoring your instincts? Now I'm talking about not their red flags, but your own internal instincts of, this stuff is happening too fast. This is too intense. Why does she want to move in when we just met? Okay, so the physical intimacy is fantastic. It's great. It's wonderful. It is the best ever. And this is the person of your dreams, you think. Did you think that way? Did that happen to you? Or is that happening to you now? But are you ignoring, or did you ignore your gut instinct when things were happening? And a person commented on a short that I did, and they said, she says, sorry, it's a bit small here. They shared that the person they're with BPD, or have been with, she says, since she's on mental leave, I need to forget about my needs and focus on her. And whether a person with BPD actually says that to you or not, that's the way it is, right? I mean, have you realized that yet? And if you're sort of past all this and you know that, it's like, but how painful is that in retrospect? And are you working that out, or are you still trying to get your ex back? And the commenter continues, so he needs to forget about his needs, and he was told. It's not just something that you can sense after a while. We're supposed to get married in a month. Yikes. I don't really want to, says the commenter. Can you relate to this? Even if it's past for you right now, or you're still in the situationship and you're trying to let go of the person with BPD because they've ghosted you and it's on off and you're in the limbo place, and it's like, you know, you don't really want to keep dating, redating, staying in a relationship, recycling a relationship. Maybe you're married. Maybe you're about to get married. Maybe there's a baby on the way. Maybe they're pressuring you. They want a baby. And you're like, gut instincts might be there. And if this is happening to you right now, are you aware that you need to listen to your gut instincts? And if it's already, what's happened has already kind of happened for you, and now you're like reeling and trying to deal with what is now, or still trying to get them back and all that limbo stuff, are you still ignoring maybe your gut instincts? What do you think? And the commenter goes on, like, you know, they're supposed to get married in a month, and he says, I really don't want to. And then I sense it'll end in tragedy. Well, yeah, these relationships with untreated people with BPD, they end really badly, and everybody, and people are so hurt, right? So hurt, yeah, which is just an understatement. And the commenter continues, I don't know how to leave. Big thing that a lot of people are going through right now, if you haven't already been through it, but you're still maybe not in a good place, a healthy place, or maybe you still haven't gotten into action in your own healing and recovery, or you're still recycling with a borderline or a narcissist. And the commenter says, yeah, they don't know how to leave. That's really difficult and very much an issue for people. And when you're aware of these things, yeah, it's a good time to stop and get help, because if you don't know what to do, but you know that you maybe probably really don't want to marry, but you know, or have that baby or move in or whatever it is, but like you do, but like it was this, something's gnawing at you. Your gut instinct says, no, this isn't good. What's going on here? This is good, but something's up. And then the commenter said that in the beginning, this person with BPD in the commenter's life said, quote, if you leave me, I will unalive myself, end quote. And I'm just changing that one word. And then they said, now what the person with BPD says to them is, quote, if I stay with you, I will unalive myself, unquote. Emotional blackmail. Setting you up to go past your instincts of what's healthy for you, because people with codependency are so programmed from childhood, various reasons, etc., to need to help more than need to protect self. And the commenter says, I guess that gives me a good reason to leave. Wow. Do you think that you need a, quote, good reason to leave? Lots of people do leave people with BPD, because there are people out there with BPD that are clingy and they don't ghost and discard. But many people have been ghosted, and you're not sure if it's a discard, maybe. But in spite of all your pain right now, maybe, because this is like, maybe somebody can come along and like this commenter came along and shared this and it's really happening. It's happening, not really. I mean, I believe people. It's happening in real time for this commenter, right? This gut instinct, this awareness. But then he says, but I don't know how to leave. Right. The good news is the commenter responded back to my comment and said they saw a therapist today. So excellent. But the thing is, so if you're somewhere further down the line in all this and you still want them back, you just you can't live with them and you can't live without them. And you're just in this big dilemma place of everything, like the cognitive dissonance, the rumination, you can't stop thinking about them, trying to go no contact, reverse hoovering, watching the social media. Why are they happier with the next person? I mean, it's all just so much for people. It really is complicated and difficult to get into a healing recovery process, which I'm out here to work with you if you resonate with me, to be able to even get to no contact. Some people go no contact first and they reach out for help. Some people really need help in trying to go no contact. And what that really means, because it has nothing to do with you should go no contact for 3 months because then you will have, quote, practiced it, or you'll know you can do it. If you've been doing it as a ploy to manipulation to get your ex back, because if you stay no contact, so you think your ex will miss you more. This works to get people back together. I would ask you to what end? And the point here is, all of those things that people do in recycling and listening to people who don't know what they're talking about out there, frankly, what you're doing is codependent. And I hate to keep just throwing that word out there. It means so much in people's lives. But the thing is, you can't, it really comes down to you want what you initially had, if that's already, you know, split to devaluation, idealization has ended. Because they don't really ever go back to what it's like in the beginning. And you're still loving this person you thought they were, and they're not that person. So have you flown by your gut instincts? Did you have awarenesses? You're going through that right now, like this commenter. Don't really know what to do. Don't really know how to leave. Because what you might not realize, it's working against you. Big part of codependency for people is that you are, maybe not consciously in a way, but unconsciously, you got programmed, so to speak. You are obsessed with not only maybe what you want, who you thought they were, which is big, huge, right? But you are obsessed actually at a deeper level with how you, from an external way, you're seeking, unconsciously, usually people do this, from that borderline or narcissist, you're actually seeking to caretake for them because you had a caretake for a parent or something similar in your family of origin, in your childhood. And so you never really learn to be fully present to yourself, knowing yourself fully, because that wounded inner child is a separation of self as you grow and become an adult. And then the thing is, so you learn to put other first, and that, you know, that from the wounded inner child in you, the deep down unconscious belief is, if I just do enough, give enough, care enough, empathize enough, sacrifice myself enough, they'll eventually give something back to me, right? They'll see me, they'll get all that I'm giving to. Do you know how many people at the end of these relationships or working to end these relationships one of the things I've heard from so many clients, they really can't believe, like, so what, everything I did for her, all the money I spent, all the house, the this, the that, whatever it is, right? And all of it, like, and I changed this, and I moved here, and I did this for her, and it was all, and what? She forgets all that? She doesn't care about any of that anymore? What happened to that? What did he get? And it's really a statement of, what about me, meaning you? And understandably so. Because I think what people need to realize is, no matter if you're in a really great place with this borderline or really not so great place, but they're untreated and you're just coming to awareness of all this, how are you still ignoring your gut instincts that tell you this can't work? You know, your head's saying up here, this can't work. But then your feelings and the cognitive dissonance and you're focused on the good part. And it's like, but it has to. Or if you'd like to comment and you're new to this and you're like, we're supposed to get married in a month and I don't think I want to, but I don't know. Is this a good reason for me to leave? I don't know how to leave. This comes from the woundedness in people's childhoods that gets replicated in this most amazing experience you probably didn't have in your childhood, of feeling like you're so seen, so heard, so unique, best looking, even if you are a fantastic looking man or woman, best looking boy. And this is the person of my dreams. This is who I've always been, my twin flame, my soulmate, but it's not really real. And so I want to just say quickly, if you can relate to this, leave a comment. You know, I'm out here to work with people, if I resonate with you, to help you through this, and you can get through it, and you can end the relationship, and you can go no contact for real. The kind that sticks for life, that helps you to pause stuff and work on things and heal. Nobody just moves on from these types of relationships because you got into them for reasons that you need to understand, work on, process, and heal. Or you wouldn't have gotten into that relationship in the first place. So are you now, or did you in the beginning or both, ignore your gut instincts, your instincts? And what's important about the gut instinct to understand is that, and people go against them all the time, so don't judge yourself or be hard on yourself. Maybe you're still doing this. You know it's not going to work out, but you just can't help that it feels like, if you could just get back there, if you could just fix, change, rescue, do something, which is, you know, or you think you did something wrong, and oh, if I just did this, and if I didn't say that, none of which is the reason for all why these relationships are impossible. But you need to look on your side more. You need to consider yourself. What about your gut instinct? What about how you really feel inside and around and in spite of all these other feelings of you want them back, because essentially you need them back, because now you become obsessed with them. Why? Because in the beginning, not only the idealization, not quote what the borderline did to you, unquote, no, where you were emotionally in the first place, unconsciously aware, you weren't aware of it. Why you? Because healthier people walk away from that intensity. Healthier people are like, whoa, I've been sitting having dinner or a date or you talked online or something for 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours. You heard everything that's ever gone wrong in their lives. That's a huge red flag. But we're not here to talk about red flags today. Today, we're, you know, the video is about how much of your gut instinct and knowing that something was wrong were you not able to pay attention to. Now, I was just going to say, because gut instinct isn't all just like feely-meely stuff or like woo-woo stuff, because we have a gut brain and it has more neurotransmitters in it than the brain in our head. And the gut brain connects to the, no, and the shin bone, no, sorry. The gut brain connects to the brain up here through the polyvagal nerve. And, you know, what we now know through neuroscience is the gut brain sends many more signals up to the head brain than vice versa. So this gut instinct stuff, this knowing stuff that you don't pay attention to, it can sometimes be misleading to us, yes. But in these situations, no. But then it's so hard to stop and listen to that intuitive, instinctual gut instinct and gut brain telling you, whoa, like, no, 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 no. Like this commenter is saying, you know, hey, she said this and like, we're supposed to get married in a month and I don't think I want to, but I don't know how to leave. And is that a good reason for me to leave? It's almost like the commenter is like thinking about, well, I need permission. It has to be okay with them for me to leave, or I'll feel guilty. I'll be doing something bad. Can you relate to any or all of this? No matter where you are right now, in on-off limbos, or wanting your ex back, or maybe like this commenter, you're just starting to realize, wow, I'm dating this girl, I'm dating this woman, dating this man, and wait a minute, because, and if they don't say exactly what this commenter's person with BPD said, you know, you need to never mind your feelings, just focus on me, meaning the person with BPD. They're always giving you that message. That's always there. But when it feels good and you're ignoring the gut instinct and you're just looking for something that you're getting fooled by something, but it's not because they're fooling you on purpose any more than you want to be fooled on purpose. Anyway, have you ever ignored, gone over, just... and now maybe realize that you didn't listen to a gut instinct? And if so, you know, I hope you can be kind to yourself about that. And I'm out here to work with people who want to stop the cycles, stop the pain, even if you are no contact. Or if the person with BPD, you know, ghosted and discarded you, and you're just like, wow, and you don't know what to do with that. And you're just like in an HE double hockey stick, kind of like, oh my God, what do I do now? And you don't know how to regulate your emotions, because that's the problem with the riding the roller coaster, you know, and the drama and the chaos and the everything. Well, that kicks in your flight, fight, or freeze, fawn response. It affects your nervous system. This is where people have sometimes PTSD from childhood, PTSD from these relationships, or some people with codependency have CPTSD as well. But that's from childhood. That doesn't just develop with the borderline or the narcissist, believe it or not. So the key thing is your nervous system is often in the overgear of trying to protect you while you're ignoring your gut instincts and you're following, sometimes for the physical intimacy part of, like, that's wonderful if that's still there after a time. But you just trauma bond, right? Because it so fools people as to being your soulmate or the love of your life. Anyway, if you can relate to anything here, if you'd like to share, please leave a comment below. And I think this is a huge thing, because people with codependency, you need to focus on yourselves more, as I'm always saying. And you can start that right now, if you haven't yet, because looking at gut instincts and feelings and inklings that you have that you went past is probably even more helpful than focusing on what were the borderline's red flags. That, you know, I didn't get the red flags. What about what your gut instinct was telling you? Because you need to get to know you better. Maybe you could start by asking yourself about, did you, like the commenter, like, we're supposed to get married, but I don't really think I want to. And, like, did you have some of those gut instinct feelings that you went past? Because if you think about that, or I'm out here to work with you if you'd like to talk about that and more, then that's at least focusing on something that you can learn about you that can help you to learn how to cope emotionally and regulate emotionally through these breakups, these ghostings, these discards, etc. And you know, not everybody with BPD hoovers. They're not all coming back. So you can't know if you're in that limbo place, revolving door, on and off. What's your gut feeling telling you now? Take care.